All right, new top ordered for the Miata. It's gonna be here in a week or so, but before we install that new top, check this thing out. Kelly and I ordered this a week or so ago. This is an M2 double diagonal hard top roll bar for our M1. This will allow us to use a top with a glass window, which is what I just ordered. Now I know you're wondering too, what's this all about, dude? These are new wheels and tires that will be going on after we do brakes and suspension. So don't worry about these. We got a huge project for today. Let me go show you what I'm talking about. Come out to the garage. Yes, so a couple weeks ago, Kelly and I were messing around with Miata, and I said to her, I wonder if this thing still has gas in it. And she said, it better not. So if you guys don't remember, this sat in a garage for 12 years before we actually got it, and to actually think that it might have gas in it was just the worst idea ever. So fortunately, when we decided to take off the fuel cover, we actually did find gas and rust inside our gas tank. So we're going to show you that in a minute, but before we do, welcome to Extreme Daily Drivers. What is up, guys? Welcome to Extreme Daily Drivers, where we are always balling on a budget and wrenching in our garage. So, as we said, we got ourselves a serious issue with our gas tank, and Kelly and I are actually going to replace it today. Now, we've never done this before. It actually should not be too terrible, but I'll be totally honest with you. We've had this gas tank for a while, like maybe 2 months. And we've been dreading installing it, just because...
And we picked a 90-degree day to do it.
We did pick a 90-degree day to do it. But it really shouldn't be too hard on this car, because the transmission is not installed, and our drive shaft is not installed. There's not much installed in this car, so that means it's a lot less stuff that we have to uninstall in order to do it. But anyway, before we actually start tearing this thing apart, let me show you exactly what we found when we start digging around a little bit on this rear package tray. So as you guys can see here, kind of got it covered up. But check out what we found underneath this, man. Oh my God. Yeah, rust. Ugh. Now, the rust is actually not on the body of the car. It's on these silly little panels. Now this right here, I actually didn't remove this one. It was just gone. It's just totally gone. And as you can see here from these little tabs that were left over, man, it's just completely rusted and disappeared. This was a surprise, no doubt about it. And what was inside of here was an even bigger surprise. Let me go ahead and grab a Phillips head screwdriver. We'll get this opened up. All right, so here's the fuel pump assembly. This is obviously trashed. As you can see, look, it's actually dripping gas. This little sock or boot, whatever. All right, so check out what's in here.
I haven't even seen this yet. Oh my gosh, that does not look good.
Dude, can you see this? Yeah, man. That's not what you want pumping through your engine. So you actually can clean out gas tanks, but we were able to go to eBay and we were able to pick a gas tank up for like $150 shipped.
Worth it.
Totally worth it. That's what's been in this box that you guys have been seeing me like spray paint everything on. We have a brand new gas tank in here that we got off of eBay, and it's awesome. All right, so check it out. Here's the tank in all its glory. We have some kind of dog-eared ends here, but that's gonna happen when you just ship it in a typical cardboard box. But for the most part, this thing is in good shape and shouldn't be too hard to get fitted underneath the car. So, first step, as always, let's jack this thing up and get it on jack stands. So now we got the car jacked up, we wanna start in the trunk. We're gonna have to loosen the shock towers and remove the struts from the top, as well as get rid of some of this piping in here. So if you guys see, I've already gotten the top one loose here, got the clip off, and now we're working on this bottom one. And this is one of those things where it's probably gonna fling gas everywhere as I slowly pull this off of the tank. You're gonna have to be able to gain access to this if you wanna replace your tank, and there's just some metal paneling that's in the way. And on ours, it wasn't connected at all. So one more step that we didn't have to do. This is close.
Yeah, it's very close. Oh, well, there you go.
There we go.
There you go.
All right. And honestly, it looks pretty darn good. It's not nearly as bad as I thought it would be. Let's see what this top one reveals.
Oop.
Oh, that one came right off. And once again, not so bad.
So now we're gonna go ahead and focus again. Get these two nuts off here at the top of the strut, as well as the two over there, over here in this corner, to be able to start to drop the subframe. Next step of dropping a subframe is to disconnect the emergency brake cables. So I already did that side. Now we're over here, you're gonna need some 14 millimeter wrenches. You're gonna want a box wrench to get it started, and then finish it off with one of these ratcheting ones. There are two of these, and they're on tight, and I always forget which way to push. I think I pushed down.
There you go.
All right, and then there's one more. And now you just kind of wrestle the cable off of the little anchor. There you go. All right, next we're gonna go ahead and disconnect this thing here. And it's something to do with the brakes. Yeah, I forget what this is called, but you gotta disconnect it from the subframe. All right, I think I said earlier that there are four subframe bolts. I lied, there's six. All right, so we got one here, and I think they're 19 millimeter. Let's see. Yep, so we got one there. We have one here. All right, and then we have one here, which you're gonna need a deep 19 in order to get that guy off. All right, guys, you can actually get a really good view of the subframe bolts from the side here. So I was able to get them all off by hand with a breaker bar and extension. Once again, it's 19 millimeter. So you have one here, all right? You have one right here, and then you have one right here. So it's the same on each side. This subframe does weigh, they say, a couple hundred pounds. So we're not just gonna go ahead and loosen these bolts and just, you know, bench press this thing. I got a transmission jack that we're gonna use to help lower this down. So one thing I wanna point out that I didn't mention earlier is if you have a power plant frame brace, whatever they're called, you're gonna wanna disconnect that. Ours is disconnected from the front of the car. I guess I'll go ahead and disconnect the three bolts in the back of the car too. But yeah, you're gonna wanna do that. All right, we got all the bolts. What do you?
I'm ready for bed.
Kelly's ready for bed? This is the scary part. We got our transmission jack under there, kind of. And now it's time to lower it down. Are you gonna lower it down?
Hell no.
I wonder what we forgot to disconnect.
Who knows?
All right, guys, we got it lowered down. I made a mistake earlier. I disconnected the wrong thing here at the rear passenger brake. You have to actually disconnect the line leading to this piece, not this piece, from subframe. So sorry about that. But yeah, anyway, that guy's leaking away, and that's fine. We got a rag underneath there. But I think we're good. All right, guys, where there's a will, there's a way. Kelly, I'm going to handle this thing. And we got it out, huh? How about that? This thing is a real pain in the butt, man. We had to pull it out just as is. It's still connected to this thing and, like, doesn't want to come off. I don't know. I'm going to play with it a little bit more. We're going to get this stupid thing off of here. But, yeah, man. 30-year-old car. And we just dropped subframe on it with really no major issues, right? I mean, we had to fight it a little bit. Just a little bit. But, yeah, nothing broke. No one died. We got this thing out. So now all that's left is to actually get to the gas tank now and replace that stupid thing. All right, guys, back under the car and check it out. There's the gas tank in all its glory. Oh, man. It's a lot of work to get to that thing, but boy, do we have all the access in the world. Looks like it's four 14 millimeter bolts. We got one here, one here, one there, and Kelly's. We got that one right there.
And there's not one on that side?
Yeah, there is. That's right there. Here's a drain bolt. If you guys ever need to drain your gas tank, there actually is one on these cars. But well, there's barely any fuel in here. I'm not worried about it. We're just going to go ahead and pull this stupid thing down and get it out of here. Well, that was pretty easy, man. That wasn't hard at all. Not bad, right?
Disconnect this hose, whatever that is.
Okay.
And then there was a screw. Actually, I don't even know if we needed to disconnect that screw.
Oh, really?
But yeah, it was just this hose really was...
That was what was holding it up?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's a 412 millimeter, not 14 like I stated earlier. But four of those, and there's actually a little helper hook
right here, which is kind of neat. You can kind of, you know, there's a hole in the tank, and that help. That's kind of like a third hand as you guide it down. So that's pretty impressive, man. 30 years old. Look how nice all this looks. It's awesome. Very cool. All right, Kelly and I transferred everything over to the new tank. Let's get this guy off of here. Mm-hmm. All right. Looking pretty sweet. You ready to install this?
Yeah, let's get it done.
Let's get it done. All right, you go ahead and grab her. Okay. All right, lower it down. This is the little help of it. See over here?
Uh-huh.
Okay, so we got that guy. Okay, I'm lined up here. If I wanted to, I could put a bolt in there. I think we got it.
I've never really been under a car before, so this is a treat.
It's pretty sweet.
All right, so those are kind of in over here.
Yeah, we need to go up top, and we need to make sure everything's good up there. So let's go up top.
Okay.
All right, so up here, I fiddled with this a little bit, but those guys are in their holes. And then up top, Kelly just went ahead and reinstalled this line here, which was holding us up from dropping the tank initially when I was underneath there. So that's reinstalled. Everything looks good up here.
Mm-hmm.
I think we can go ahead and tighten those bolts down.
Yeah, let's do it.
All right, we got this thing installed. Not going anywhere. And while we're under here, we may as well go ahead and change out the fuel filter. And we got a new one. So let's grab a Phillips head and pull that little cover off, and then we'll pull the lines off. All right, we got the cover off. Kelly is removing the to and from of the filter with those silly little clips. So we got one of the lines off.
Probably not a good time to smoke a cigarette.
Fuel start coming out all over the place. And yeah, it was funny because that was like Kelly's first time dealing with a really stuck hose. And it did not want to go. You can see we got WD-40 and a little screwdriver.
Oh,
man, it did not want to come off. Well, still spewing. So anyway, yeah. You want to make sure you get the hoses off before you loosen that clamshell that is holding the filter in place. Trust me. Otherwise, you'll just be reinstalling it because you can't get leverage when that thing is not hooked up right. So we got one more to get off of there. And then we're going to be replacing it with this sweet one from Wix. There's the part number if you need it. All right, new filter installed. She ain't going nowhere. This is what somebody who's building a car, this is what their stuff looks like. Right? Guys, we did it. It's back together. Kelly and I were just talking about how
it looks like nothing happened.
It looks like we didn't even do anything. But trust me, there's new gas tank underneath there. You can see it up here. Now, we didn't replace this yet, or this, or the panel that goes over there, but we will. There's our replacement panel for the package tray, and then we actually have new panels here, as well as new hardware for these panels. So anyway, make sure you like, make sure you subscribe. Next week is when the roll bar goes in, and we're literally, this car is going to start transforming. So make sure you subbed. Make sure you're watching every episode. Make sure you give us a like for all the work we did today. We dropped the rear subframe and replaced the gas tank. Look how dirty Kelly is. Look at this. This is evidence of work that had been done.
Her poor nails.
Her poor nails. So yeah, make sure you sub.
Give us some love.
Give us some love. Check us out on Instagram. Kelly posts a ton of stuff on there that doesn't make the video.
KMA224.
There you have it. And you know me, Extreme Daily Drivers. So anyway, guys, thanks so much for watching.
Please like, please subscribe, and we'll see you next time.
We'll see you next time. Later.
Bye.